Hey guys, Lawrence here from Unicorn Reviews. This is my bazillion take on this video because I'm not doing very well today. As you can see, I actually shrunk half a meter or something. So today we're looking at the Mad Catz Rat 1 mouse, an old plastic construction mouse. So it's only 50 grams. If like me, you come from something like an MX Master, that's a third of the weight. It's quite an experience at first. But that does not mean that the internals are bad, not at all. So basically the clicks, the mouse buttons, those are made by Omron and perfectly even distribution across the button. Really like it. The scroll wheel, also very, very good. Steps are super well defined, I really like it. Behind that scroll wheel is another toggle button. You can use that to just go forward, backwards in your browser. You can also set it up to do just about whatever you want. The sensor in there is an optical 3500 DPI sensor by Pixart. It's the PWM or the PMW, can't quite remember, 3500 sensor. Very good, tracks on this cork desk, which is all I ever wanted because this one has a lot of holes in it, a lot of bumps on it. It still works. It worked great on my clump mouse mat as well, so that's awesome. So let's talk a little bit about what I don't like about this product because there are quite a few things. For example, the cable is heavier than the actual mouse. What that means is that if you even slightly move the cable, or if the cable is still stiff, because it is quite a stiff one, the mouse moves around just like that. So not that good. And there are more problems. Now, I am a palm grip user, so not everything will apply to you, maybe if you're a claw grip person. But for me, putting the slightest bit of weight on here makes the front lift up. Now, if I then tilt that weight to the left, to the right, it actually lifts the front up in one or two directions. So the front left or the front right lifts up, not handy at all. Now, as you can see, I'm trying to put the mouse on my desk so you guys can see it, and the cable is enough to move it backwards. So that sucks. But then Mad Catz kind of gives you a half-assed solution. So they, in their marketing material, there's a lot of stuff about the palm grip rest thingy, this plastic thingy here, being 3D printable. Yeah, they use that word again. And what that means is that they give you a little RAR file, and in there are a few STL files. Now, those are used to make 3D printings. I imported them into what I usually use, which is SolidWorks. Dimensions were completely off. I used it with the Microsoft 3D Builder. It actually worked, so you can then grab those files and you can put your name in there or alter the design ever so slightly, make it maybe bigger, make it smaller, whatever you want. Now, the frame also has an option to put the palm rest slightly further forward. If you do that, then the tilting problem is solved somewhat, but the problem at that point is that the frame is way too short. And talking about that frame being a completely plastic thing, why on earth do we not get models for that Mad Catz? Seriously, for me, if I were to actually use this mouse, which I would really like to do because it is a really good front module, but if I could just design a frame that's maybe 2-3 centimeters longer and has 2 or 3 contact points at the rear to help with stability, I would be so happy. Now, the problem is the mouse is €30. Just printing this plastic palm rest is like €13 for the cheapest plastic print you can possibly get. So if you don't have a 3D printer already, you're kind of screwed. And I don't really think that the person buying a €3,000 3D printer is also going to buy a €30 mouse, unless maybe purely for the idea of making some custom things. Now, I've had a look at the README file, and if you're maybe looking into designing a few of these, maybe designing a frame after measuring the front module for 2 days because they didn't give you the CAD files, you may want to start a little business out of that. Mad Catz says, nope, not for commercial use. That's kind of sucky because it would be quite cool if people would make different frames and just sell them for like $1 each or something. Not allowed. So for a conclusion, the front module of this mouse, really good. It's super lightweight. I really like that. But then Mad Catz completely screwed up with the shape and the design of the thing. It's completely unstable. And the only thing they give you files for is this backplate, which is super expensive to print. And that is super expensive if you just go with the cheapest plastic. You can make it out of titanium for $300 if you want to. So guys, if you like this video more than I like this mouse, there's that like button. If you didn't, there's the subscribe button for when I make a video that you do like. If you want to follow the channel, we have Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for gorgeous pictures all the time. And if you want to support the channel, we obviously have Patreon and paypal.me. For now though, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.